Welcome to Bible Tract Echoes. This program is the radio ministry of Bible Tracts Incorporated. Our mission is to take the Word of God to all the world. Our Bible teacher is the director of Bible Tracts, Pastor Mark Smith. Since 1938, Bible Tracts Incorporated has been publishing clear gospel tracts and supplying them to churches, missionaries, and individuals all over the world, and all at no charge. Information on how you can receive a free sample pack of our tracts will be given at the end of this broadcast. Now for our Bible study, here is our teacher, Pastor Mark Smith.
Welcome, my friend. Welcome to the broadcast. Thank you so much for letting me join you today and you being part of our program on this, the Friday edition of Bible Tract Echoes. My Bible is open again, as it always is. It's open again to the book of 2 Thessalonians and chapter 3. We're near to the very, very end of the book. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3. I'm going to begin reading at verse 13 here. If you can, reach over, pick up your own copy of the Word of God and join me there. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3. Get something to write with and write on for two reasons. Number one, so you can take some notes as we go along so that you can remind yourselves of what we study here and apply it to our lives. But also, with that pen and paper ready, you can jot down our contact information. I want to give you a free sample packet containing one each of all of our English gospel tracts. I'm going to talk about one of those gospel tracts in a moment, but I want to begin this way. Have you had the joy of raising teenagers? Oh, teenagers, what joy. They can be so joyous that sometimes you want to give them away. Amen? Well, now, I do know that within the body of Christ, there are different views about the subject of teenagers and dating, and I'm not going to take a stand on that issue today. But let me ask, have these words ever been heard in your ears from a teenage girl? I'm going to pick on the girl today, pardon me. But have you ever heard words like this? Oh, Mom, Bobby broke up with me. I'm devastated. I thought he really liked me. What am I going to do now? How can I ever go back to school and see my friends again? How can I show my face? Mom, I'm never going to have another boyfriend again as long as I live. Have you ever heard that? Well, please, whatever you do, don't try to use logic with a teenager at that moment in time. They're too emotional. Friend, listen to me. Teenagers can be logical, but not when they're emotional. They're just like us adults. But before too long, guess what happens to this teenage girl? Your daughter, your granddaughter has met a new guy, new Mr. Right. And she really didn't mean it when she said she would never have a boyfriend again. The simple thing was she got burned with Bobby. Now, do you know that local churches can get burned as they try to do the work of God? They can ponder. Local churches can provide help for somebody who they thought was really in need, and then they discover otherwise. Sometimes churches will say, well, that's it. We're not going to help anybody ever again. Well, friend, if you understand that thought pattern, then you're going to understand the passage before us today here in 2 Thessalonians chapter 3. Get your Bible and join me. Before I begin reading at verse 13, I want to encourage you to use gospel tracts as part of your day-to-day outreach to the lost. Though there's a gospel tract in my hand right now, and again, I remind you, all that a gospel tract is a short written presentation of telling somebody how to know Jesus Christ as their Savior. The one in my hand right now is entitled Memorial Stones. Memorial Stones. On the front, there's a picture of a military cemetery with all the identical gravestones there in those straight lines. And it begins with these words, Daddy, please tell me about these stones. And the dad begins to answer, well, son, these stones are loving memorials of departed loved ones. They mark the graves of moms and dads, brothers and sisters, grandmothers and grandfathers, and so on. But it goes on to say, these speak of, and then it mentions these categories. Death is certain, the certainty of death, the suddenness of death. Death can come to the old as well as the young. and we must be ready for death. Here's a great gospel tract. I encourage you to get it. It'll be part of that sample packet I want to send you. At the end of the broadcast, my announcer will give you our contact information. Please give us your name, give us your mailing address. We'll send it to you absolutely free of charge. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 13 says this, "But ye, brethren, be not weary in well-doing. And if any man obey not our word by this epistle, note that man, and have no company with him, that he may be ashamed. Yet count him not as an enemy, but admonish him as a brother." Stop right there. The passage today that we're looking at has a rather well-known phrase in it, that phrase, "be not weary in well-doing." The same phrase can be found over in the book of Galatians in chapter 4. You may have, as I do, a note in the margin of your study Bible that word weary can also be translated with the idea of faint or giving up. Every Bible teacher, now you do know this, don't you? Every Bible teacher, they're going to agree on the major truths found in the Word of God. They may differ on some of the lesser truths, but one of the things that Bible teachers can disagree on is how to arrange a Bible passage. Now, in this particular case, some Bible teachers put verse 13 with verses 14 and 15. They think those three go together. But I'm one of those that think verse 13 fits best with verses 10, 11, and 12. In verses 10, 11, and 12, there, God tells Paul what to say to this particular local church when they have a believing member or members who are shirking. They are not working at a gainful employment to take care of their day-to-day needs. And these non-working believers were expecting the other saints in the church to take care of them and meet their needs. And yesterday, I used three words, all beginning with the letter T, one word for each verse, 10, 11, and 12. They were these. For verse 10, the word is teaching. Verse 11, the word is transgression. Verse 12, the word is toil, as in hard work. But now I want to add one more word beginning with the letter T for verse 13. And that is the word task, T-A-S-K, the word task. The body of believers does have the task of bearing one another's burdens. Often, this means that we simply pray for one another. Often it means that we give words of encouragement and Bible verses to each other. But bearing one another's burdens, sometimes it means literally helping to feed and house fellow saints. Because some shirking saints weren't working, they became a wrongful burden to the church. The saints got tired of helping them and probably became leery of anybody and all people who were saying, "I need some help." So the Holy Spirit says in verse 13, don't be weary in helping those saints who truly need it. Helping one another is a good work. It's what's called a well-doing work here. Helping to support one another was a godly task that this local church was to maintain. They were, though, to discern if some were unworthy of help due to sheer laziness. Now, that being said, let me move into verses 14 and 15. These two verses are the final verses in this section. The section started back at verse 6. And so far, from beginning at verse 6, we've looked at the disorderly life in a believer's there, some of the believers in the church. We looked at the derelict life. And now, verses 14 and 15, we look at the disobedient life. What do you and I do when a true child of God practices flagrant disobedience? Now, keep in mind here what's been said already. Back at verse 7, I read these words, "For yourselves know how ye ought to follow us." Now, how to practice a godly daily lifestyle had already been taught to this local church by the Apostle Paul. They knew it from before. Then, in verse 10, the Apostle Paul says again, "When we were with you, this we commanded you." Now here in verses 6 through 13, this congregation is a third time taught how to live. You would think, well, what does that old phrase say? A third time's a charm. You would think by the third time that these shirking saints had heard the truth, they'd heard the same truth taught, this third installment, you would think they would get with the program and start living a godly life in this area. But Verse 14 says, if any man obey not our word by this epistle, note that man, and have no company with him, that he may be ashamed. This step is the step that's best known to you and me by the term excommunication. A lot of people don't like that term. It conjures up all kinds of bad experiences in a local church. But it's an idea here. Excommunication, not keeping company, is the idea of having no fellowship with a blatantly sinning brother or sister. In other passages, we're told to not even eat a meal with them. I don't think that applies to the immediate family, but it does apply to the church saints. But does this mean then that we simply write off this blatantly sinning saint? Absolutely not, because verse 15 says, we still consider this person a brother, a sister, a believer in Christ. We are to make opportunities to speak to them so that we can do what verse 15 says, we can admonish him. Rather than gossip and talk about this sinning believer behind their back, perhaps, well, not perhaps, a far better, more godly approach would be to go and to say something like this. Dear Brother Joe, we missed you. You missed a very touching time last Sunday night at our monthly communion service. Sister Mary gave a tremendous testimony of how God saved her life from sin and what God was doing to transform her life. Oh, Brother Joe, you missed it. You should have been there. I wish you could have been there. Or perhaps this. Oh, Brother Joe, we had our Sunday school party last Friday. We sure missed you. People openly spoke of how much they wish you could be part of our class again. We all openly prayed and asked God to give you his repenting grace. Brother Joe, you need the fellowship of our church. Our church needs you in it, but not before you get your disorderly life dealt with. Oh, Brother Joe, get right with God. We love you. We miss you. You need to follow and obey Christ. I wonder what would happen if local church discipline were done with that kind of an attitude, with a brokenheartedness. I'm sad to say that it doesn't matter what denomination you may be. If the Bible teaches that you and I are to discipline blatantly sinning saints, then we all ought to do it. But dear friend, whether you're a Baptist, Methodist, Nazarene, whatever the case may be, sometimes we don't do church discipline well, and it brings a stink onto our local assembly, and it's a stink that won't go away until we repent of it. Repenting of a wrong attitude. Six things does the Lord hate, yea, seven are an abomination unto him. A proud heart is often found in the lives of people who are practicing this whole church discipline idea. They do it with a proud heart rather than a broken heart. They do it not with the heart of Christ. As we get ready for joint worship, for corporate worship this coming Lord's Day, we can't do it well unless our hearts are broken and tender and say, what does that old song say? It's not my father, not my mother, but it's me, O Lord, standing in the need of prayer. O friend, let's go for corporate worship with a brokenness over our own issues. And then we're offering grace to others and say, we can find grace and forgiveness in the heart of God, in the cross of Christ. Amen.
Thank you for joining us today for Bible Tract Echoes. If you would like to receive a free sample packet of our tracts, you can contact us by calling 309-828-6888. Our mailing address is Bible Tracts, P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. Again, our phone number is 309-828-6888, and our mailing address is P.O. Box 188, Bloomington, Illinois, 61702. You can also contact us through our website. Our web address is BibleTractsInc.org. Remember, the word tracts is spelled T-R-A-C-T-S. That address is BibleTractsInc.org. May the Lord richly bless you as you serve Him.